In my personal experience, I juggle a full-time job, I am a freelance UI UX designer and Webflow developer. I also make videos here on YouTube. So here are some side income ideas for you to grow your income. Bear in mind that this all takes time to grow, so pick something that you're into and not just because of the money. As a designer, the no-brainer is to do freelance UI UX design. If your employer allows it, moonlighting on the side can actually help you build expertise, build experience with other clients, learn how to handle the project from end to end. It also helps you build portfolio while you're actually working on your day job. For example, when I freelance for clients, I have touched admin tools, which is kind of like internal dashboards. I've also learned how to design products for different industries and not just limited to what I'm working on my day job. If UX research is your thing, feel free to bundle in together with your design services. That way you could charge more and at the same time you could learn how to research for clients, build your expertise. In your day job, there are things that you don't get to do, right? But in a freelance project, usually you have full autonomy to do whatever you want. This is a time where you get to build a product from scratch, from researching, designing, you know, wireframing, building the design systems, showing to a client, pitching your idea. So I highly recommend trying out freelance UI UX design for the portfolio and also for the side income. Another thing you could try is to do freelance Webflow development for your clients. If building websites are your thing and you would like to learn how websites function under the hood and how it's built, then I think it's a good time for you to learn Webflow development because that makes you a lot more valuable as a designer. You don't need to learn code to learn Webflow, but Webflow is something that gives you the flexibility to scale a site with custom JavaScript code or have full control over how you want your site to behave. I would say there's a learning curve to learn Webflow, but it's not impossible. Dedicate an hour a day to learn Webflow using their tutorials. I would say Webflow tutorials are an excellent place to start, so you don't have to pay for expensive courses for now. Webflow took me 2 weeks to learn the basics and to build a real site for a client. It varies from person to person. Give yourself some time to pick it up. If you'd like to support me as an independent creator, feel free to sign up with Webflow in the video description down below. And if you're not sure what website to build, build your own personal website. This leads me to the next point. Leverage on your personal website to build side income. Having a website is the most important thing. If you don't have a website yet, it's time to start building one. Even if it's simple, minimal, and only has a few lines, but at least people know where to find you. Make it easy for people to contact you, to look at your past work, to see what you're good at. Your personal website doesn't need to be perfect. Don't spend months trying to build a personal site. As for me, my personal site has evolved from a crappy HTML coded site. It went through many iterations to get to where it is today. Eventually ended up with a no-code tool like Webflow. So this is my site. Is it perfect? Hell no. I didn't intend to spend like hours or days onto my site. I just made it a rule of thumb to launch it over the weekend and get it over with. Every time I have a little idea or inspiration from my website, I would just hop onto Webflow and start tweaking it. The rule of thumb is if something takes days to build and it generates little to no impact for you, don't overdo it. I would recommend just allocating one day to design and then start building it on Webflow already. Aim to launch your personal site in within 3 days. If you have time to refine the interaction, the design of the website, and to refine the content to show off more of your personality and also your work, it would be a plus point for clients to hire you for design work or Webflow development work or any other work that you offer. It can be an engine for you to drive leads if you're looking for clients or freelance projects. You know, sometimes people come across your personal site and realize, hey, I can think of this person for a specific job. They will think of you and they know how to contact you and where to share your portfolio to their own network of people. So having a personal site is really, really important. Try to leverage on SEO to drive leads. When your SEO becomes stronger and stronger, people will find you through organic search easily. Your investment in building your personal site will pay off. Once you're familiar with Webflow, it's time for you to try selling Webflow templates. It's beginning to grow as a no-code tool for website development. Many major brands, startups are using Webflow to build their own sites and landing pages. So if you build a Webflow template, maybe it's a UI kit, maybe it's a marketing landing page, there are companies who buy Webflow templates just because they didn't want to hire a Webflow developer outright. So they will buy these templates, drag and drop, edit some content, change the branding, the colors, the fonts, just launch their landing page fast. But I'd also like to share Nikolai's article. He is also a Webflow developer who already has launched a few templates online. He has shared that the difference between a client project that gives you $5,000 versus a product is that the product can be sold again and again and again. It took Nikolai around 45 hours to design and build his first Webflow template. In the first month, he has generated around $1,000 in sales. But that's only the first month. Who's to say that in the second month onwards, it wouldn't take off, or, you know, maybe 1 year later, that template just blew up. Eventually, he would gain a lot of sales. Speaking of selling, as a designer, you could sell your UI kit, you could sell Figma templates, icons, illustrations, Notion templates, or even your own notes in any form, right? So an example I'd like to share with you for inspiration is this designer named Trav. Has made $100,000 in 6 days by selling custom iOS 14 icons. And these icons cost $28 per pack. The fun part is it only took him 2 hours to build those icons. Well, the boost of sales is due to MKBHD, but if he hasn't started building something in the first place, then, you know, how would it even take off? How would people start marketing his product for him for free? Everyone knows something and everyone can make a digital product. The next way to earn some side income is by starting a YouTube channel. This is something that you can't predict whether it's gonna guarantee you any income or not. If you find that you enjoy doing YouTube videos, it could become a viable source of income. People make full-time living out of YouTube only. As your channel grows, brands will come and ask you for sponsorships, and that's how you earn more income. The next thing is to launch a paid newsletter. If you already have a blog, try turning it into a source of income for yourself. Basically, what you can do is start collecting emails from people who show intent in your content. Start by asking people to subscribe to your newsletter and eventually turning it into a paid newsletter or a gated newsletter for some special content. For example, you can offer free design tips for your subscribers. For deeper insights in your newsletter, your subscribers can pay a fixed amount every month to view them. If you intend to keep your newsletter free for your subscribers, then maybe this is the time for you to find sponsorships to place ads on your newsletter so that you still get a main source of income. An example here that I would like to share with you is Lenny Rachitsky. He was a former Airbnb product manager and he's earned $65,000 in his first year launching his own paid newsletter. Until today, it is also one of the strongest product management newsletter in the world. The tool I use to build my own newsletter is called Button Down. This is a tool that is simple to use and free for your first 1,000 subscribers. Button Down doesn't have complicated interfaces and hidden fees, so it's kind of why I supported them in the first place, and also because it's run by one person only, and I like supporting indie creators, so this is why I highly recommend Button Down if you are considering to start your own newsletter. The next thing I would highly recommend is to teach what you know. Everyone knows something, and I know right now the imposter in you is going like, but I don't know anything, or I'm not an expert in my subject. Well, there are two ways to go about this. First thing is that maybe you're an expert in what you do. This is when you can start teaching what you know in a form of a course, an ebook, maybe a podcast even. But if you're still learning and you're a beginner in your subject matter, what you can offer is a beginner's perspective, which most experts would have missed out because they've already went past that stage. By sharing what you have learned would actually help a lot of people. You can leverage on social media platforms or, you know, your own newsletter, your own blog, on Twitter, LinkedIn, on YouTube even. Don't limit yourself to what you can teach. The next form of side income that I would recommend you to try is paid mentorship. There are many people looking for mentors and they are willing to pay for it. If you're starting out in mentorship and you don't know whether is this for you, or, you know, you're not sure how to start, I would recommend a platform called ADP List. If you find out that you actually love mentorship and you have slowly practiced and honed the skills of mentoring people, then it's time to consider whether you want to turn it into a paid gig or not. If you do decide to turn it into a paid mentorship program, then you could use a platform like Superpeer, and people will pay you for your time and knowledge. The next way to earn side income is to offer consultation. There are platforms like Superpeer or Calendly that enables you to streamline your consultation gig. Clients can actually book your time and make payment prior to the session. These are the 10 ways that you can earn side income as a UI UX designer. I would like to end this video with a last takeaway for you. Always give value before you ask. This is the number one rule for building a network, building an audience, or selling anything in the first place. So do something enjoyable to you, spend time improving your craft, and the money will come. Hope this video is helpful to you. If it is, feel free to subscribe, comment, like, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.